Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. Now I've just finished doing the last video and I've put my lipstick, my coral lipstick back on, and my eyes already been watering. Now let me get settled into this next video. And I just got to say that my name is Ali M and it has been 10 hours since I did my last makeup shop. Because I am a makeup addict and I admit it. And I was feeling a bit low yesterday and I went online and did a bit of a makeup shop. And I couldn't resist having heard about this tip and trying it out with the tan, getting the bronzers, as you know. Now, I have now got three of them. Having said, how many bronzers do you need? How different can it be before it came out? I'm loving this formula so much and the way it makes your skin feel, that having heard that you can use it as a powder and realizing it's nearly half the price of an airbrush powder, I now have three of them. There is no saving me. But I know that you will all be intrigued to see the difference between shades. So in the name of science, I just had to, because you all want to know about shades. That's my excuse and I'm sticking to it. So let me just show you. So first I'm in, and you know at some point I've now got baby bronze and I've got mummy bronze. I'm gonna have to get baby son bronze and baby daughter bronze and mummy bronze. You know at some point I'm gonna have to get daddy bronze, i.e. dark, just to complete the set. But I really don't need that right now. So I'm sure one day it will happen. Okay, so let us first show you shade one. So shade one is fair. Now, for those who are thinking, why has she bought a fair bronzer? This is all to do with, I think it was, let me just check something. I think it was KJ that said this on my live, but please correct me if I'm wrong, because I would like to credit whoever it was that said this. She said, have you heard that people are using Charlotte's bronzer as a face setting powder in a lighter shade? And I thought, oh, that's a bit weird. And then I got to thinking about it. Then I tried using my tan, as you know, and I like the finish. So this is the shade fair, and I'm going to swatch you this on my second finger. So that is fair. All right, I'm going to get to the airbrush flawless powders in a minute. Okay, so just hold on and I'll do some comparisons there. Right, then we have medium. Then we have the tan. Okay, so I know a lot of you are wondering which shade to get. And in fairness, no one has asked me about deep. But if anybody does, just let me know and I'll see if I can find out. I know that I can get use out of all three of these. And I possibly at some point could get use out of the deep. But most people have been asking me, should I get fair or medium, or should I get medium or tan? And I haven't had anyone asking me, should I get tan or deep? But that doesn't mean that there aren't people that need to know. And I know there will be people out there. So do let me know. And we'll see if we can find out for you, or you can tempt me into getting the deep. Okay, so those are the difference. So fair, medium, tan. Okay, now let me just show you them. Let me see if I can get them all into the camera. Actually, I'm just going to put a picture here because I took a picture of them all. If I try and hold them all up, you know what's going to happen. I'm going to drop one of them and break them, and then I'll be really upset. Okay, so coming up now. Okay, also, some of you might want to see some arm swatches. So you can barely see the fair one on this photo because of my, even on the palest part of my arm, you can barely see it. But here is a picture of all three shades on the palest part of my arm. Now, I know another question that has been on everyone's lips is the comparison between the bronzers, the airbrush bronzers, and the airbrush flawless finish powder. So I have got shades 1 and 2 of the airbrush flawless finish powder, but I've also got a sample of shade 3. I never actually got shade 3, although I was tempted to get one and use it as a bronzer or even a sculpt, but I never got it. So you can see these against these powders. There's the fair bronzer. Now, a lot of people are saying that this is very similar. It looks quite similar in tone to the medium airbrush powder. So I'm just trying to open now the medium airbrush powder with one hand, and it's not happening. One second, I'll be right back. By the way, that's the advantage of the bronzers. They're in magnetic closures, whereas these have got clip closures. So they're just not as easy to open, whereas the bronzers would be, you'd be able to open them with one hand because it's magnetic. Okay, so we have, here is the medium shade 2 of the airbrush flawless powder, and here is shade 1 of the bronzer, and as you can see, they look quite similar in the pan. But the question is, and I haven't tried this yet, do they look similar on the swatch? So let me just take, this is the medium powder, and I'm going to swatch the bronzer on the other hand. Right, that's the fair bronzer. Okay, so this does look paler, slightly paler than this. You see that? I'm gonna put pictures as well. Okay, let me show you the fair powder on this hand. So there is the fair powder. So you can see, if you were fair skinned, there's the fair powder, number one, and there's the fair bronzer. So that would look lovely on fair skin. Okay. Now I should have put this on the other finger because I wanted to show them together. Let me take that off. Fair bronzer next to the fair powder. All right, now next we're going to go and look at the medium bronzer. In it, so that's the medium bronzer next to the medium powder. And then I'm going to get my little sample of shade 3 of the airbrush powder. Right, there is shade 3 of the airbrush powder. And then I'm going to take tan. Okay. So airbrush powder, airbrush bronzer. Fair, medium, dark or tan. And obviously there is a darker bronzer. There's 4 shades in the bronzer. So I'm thinking actually the airbrush powder in shade 3 is quite similar to the airbrush bronzer in medium. Obviously it's warmer. The bronzers are always going to be warmer. Yeah, and then the medium powder is quite similar to the fair. Similar-ish to the fair bronzer. Now, bearing that in mind, let me just show you, last of all, before we finish off, and I will put some pictures at the end. Right, fair bronzer and the fair powder. I use this a lot, you see, under my eyes and to highlight the face. And then I'm just going to, again, show you the medium powder next to fair, because I think they're quite similar. Okay, then I'll show you the medium bronzer next to the medium powder. And then I will show you the tan bronzer next to shade 3 of my sample. What I might do actually is put this card and try and get all of that in the same photograph so that you can see the powders next to the bronzers. I hope that's been helpful, but do ask me if you need me to do anything else with them. But I just wanted to finish by, I'm just going to leave this, I'm not touching this up again. I have put on quite a bit of powder today, but to just show you, if I use the fair bronzer, which I've gone and lost again. No, it's here. This is the fair one. With my airbrush. It works perfectly as a face powder on me. And it just gives a more of a glowing finish. Now, I know I've been using other powders today, so I will make sure that in my next video, you see me doing this from scratch. But to whoever actually first introduced this idea, because I think Kay, is it Kay? Actually got it from another video. Well done. What a brilliant idea. And you get more of this for your money than the airbrush powder. Let's do a comparison of all three powders, shall we, in terms of price and cost. So I'm going to compare the airbrush flawless powder with the genius loose powder and the bronzing powder coming up next. So let's go from highest cost to lowest cost, shall we? So first we have the airbrush powder, which costs £35 and has 8 grams of product. That's half the amount of the bronzer. Okay, and it works out at £43.75 per 10 grams of product. So that's the most expensive. Then the second expensive is the loose magic powder. The loose magic powder will cost you £33. There's 13 grams of product in the loose powder, and it works out at £25.38 per 10 grams. So a lot cheaper than the pressed powder. But then the cheapest of the three is the new airbrush bronzer, which will cost you £39 to buy, but you are getting 16 grams of product for your money, which works out at £24.38 per 10 grams. So that's nearly half the price of the airbrush powder. But it's not always about cost, is it? It's also about what is the most suitable product for you. So in this next part, I'm talking about the differences between the powder and the bronzer. Not it, it's not going to give you a matte appearance, but it will enable you to set your foundation. Okay, if I wanted something matte, let me just take a airbrush powder. I'll just put this down my nose. That's going to mattify more. But if you want a bit more of a glow and you're not worried about shiny areas, so that's the powder in the middle. If you want a bit more glow. So I think if you're using tan in the bronzer, if you're of the colour that would use tan in the bronzer, you can get away with using fair as your powder. Or if you use medium airbrush powder, normally it's very similar. See? Hope that's been helpful. Okay, I didn't mention the Genius Magic powder. That's the loose one. Now, who would that be for? I think, well, the loose magic powder is also leaves you a bit more glowy than the airbrush powder, which is more mattifying. And I think maybe if you're wanting something that leaves you with a bit more glow than the airbrush powder, which is mattifying, then, and you're maybe fairer skinned, and so you're not going to be able to use the bronzer, then I would go for the Genius Magic powder. And as you can see, it is a lot cheaper than the pressed powder still. It's only a pound more than the bronzer per 10 grams. And by all accounts, they have now got rid of the unpleasant smell. So that may be an option for you if you're fair and you want a glowier look. Now I want to move on to another couple of products that I got. And then we'll finish off for the day. And any questions, let me know. So let's move on. Now, one of the reasons I went on, I want to say, by the way, a massive well done to Look Fantastic as a company. I ordered these products, not the Charlotte Tilbury, but the other things that you're about to see, at 20 to 12 last night. And they were on my doorstep at 9:30 this morning. I've just never known anything like it. And it does actually say on their website, order before midnight for next day delivery. And they meant it. So I'm just very impressed. And it cost me, the expedited next day delivery cost me £3. Charlotte Tilbury, will you please take note? I understand that there are staff shortages at the moment with COVID and everything else. And no one is expecting anyone to dispatch that quickly. Even though Look Fantastic managed to do it, we understand, I understand that, you know, through social distancing, you may not be able to have as many people in your packing department and people are off sick. Everybody gets that, right? But these companies are still all using DPD and Hermes, which is what Charlotte used, is DPD. So I don't understand why there's no option for expedited delivery anymore. And I've emailed Charlotte Tilbury, and for the first time ever, they've completely ignored my email. Now, again, there is no excuse for that, because presumably you have people working from home who have laptop access. So it does not excuse not answering an email. And I just don't understand why deliveries are taking 8 days. Hence, I bought my bronzers today from Selfridges, not from Charlotte Tilbury, because I don't want to wait 8 days for my delivery. Okay, anyway, rant over. But Look Fantastic. Thank you so much. Overnight delivery, absolutely fantastic. Now, this is what I ordered for my eyes, which have been watering. This stuff is really amazing. I probably should get out the habit of putting this on over my makeup, because it's probably going to get makeup all over it. But, oh, it is so soothing on the eye. This is called it's like putting an ice cube almost under your eye. This is called the Filorga Optimize Refresh Revitalizing Eye Contour Stick. And you can see there it is. And I just always wipe it down afterwards to make sure if I've got any makeup on it, then I can kind of get it off at the end, right? So, and it's got a little thing to protect it from getting knocked, because it's like a stick, you know, and it's quite fragile, the stick, you know, it's not like Vaseline or anything, it's quite fragile. But oh boy, is it cooling. And it has actually, when I get into the process of my eyes water, that makes under my eyes sore, which then makes my eyes water, and it becomes a vicious circle. This has been breaking that vicious circle today. It's kind of stops it from my eyes water, it gets under my eyes, that makes my eyes sore. I put some of that on and that is immediately soothed, and it stops my eyes watering again and again to try and compensate. So I'm really loving that. It's £25, but for me at the moment, worth every penny. I don't know. The only thing is, I'm not sure how long it's going to last, but so handy to put in your bag. And my first impression is I'm really happy with that. Now, Filorga, I got this on Look Fantastic. And I believe you can also get Filorga from Marks and Spencer's. And the ingredients in this are hyaluronic acid, marine extracts, and invisible micro powders. So it'll kind of give you a bit of brightening as well. It says combines ingredients to intensely moisturize the skin and leave the eyes refreshed and restore radiance to the eye contour area. And I love it. It really is very, very good for my purposes. Really soothing, really cooling. Love, 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 love. Happy girl. Right. Moving on. I got a blush from Natasha Denona. And it's a coral blush. I've been looking at coral blushes and I saw this and I did that. Be still, my heart. I love the look of this. I looked at a few reviews and I thought, I'm going to chance it. Now, this is a first impression. I don't know how long it's going to last, but I've had this on today and it seems to have lasted quite well. Here it is. I will show you and I will tell you what flavour it is. So that is the blush duo and it's called... one of them is called Tutu and the other one is called Golden Caribbean. Okay, and I'll just swatch you that on my fingers. Beautiful coral. That's what sold it to me. Look. I'm such a coral lover. And that. Now, this is quite a subtle highlight. It's not shimmer, shimmer, shimmer. But I've got plenty of those anyway. And I just thought the colours went well together. And as you can probably see, I put some of this on my eyes. Now, this is not what's on my lids. What went on my lids just didn't really look shimmery enough for my lids. It looked a bit bland, to be honest. So I've actually put Eyes to Mesmerize in Bet on my lids and a little bit of highlighter over the top. But this is the shade that is in the crease with a bit of brown from the Desert Haze palette at the end there. So let me just show you. So I'll put a little bit more on to refresh my blush so that you can see what it looks like. I'll just get my blush brush. Okay, I'll just take it into the coral. Looks a bit scary, doesn't it? I'll just tap some off on my hand. Now, you could easily overdo this, as I've probably just done now, because I still had plenty on from this morning. But what's great about this is when you put the highlightery bit on, it does actually mellow it down. So if you've overdone it a little bit, I'm going to just deliberately overdo it on the other side now. If you overdo it and you take the other one, this brush as well is Charlotte's blush brush, and it's quite stiff, and so it's quite easy to over apply. But it's also because I've already got some on. Now, if I then take some of the highlights, I'm just going to put it on with the blush brush and just put some of that above. It really helps to blend it out, and it's quite nice. I quite like it as a highlighter because it's not too in your face. It reminds me quite a bit of, there's another highlighter I've got by Tom Ford that's like it. It's just, it's not bling. It's classy. It's not too blingy. But it just gives the face a nice glow. So I'm really loving that. And as you can see, it's lasted quite well on the eyes. You can see it there in the socket. And my eyes have been watering, and I've been to visit Mick in the hospital and come back. Not visited him, of course, you're not allowed to visit, but I've dropped off some items for him. And he just happened to be at the nurse's station when I popped in. We weren't allowed to go near one another, but he did come up to the nurse's station because I texted him before I went in to say, I'm just about to come in with your stuff. So he made sure he got near to the entrance so that we could see one another. So I'm missing him, and I think he's missing me too. Anyway, I'm on a tangent again. So that's my Natasha Denona. I'm very happy with that. I will give you an update. But it certainly lasted quite well on my eyes today, considering my eyes have been quite watery and everything else. And I love the colour. And this wasn't in Temptalia's listed ones. She did a column about coral blushes, and she did one of Natasha Denona's singles. And I just didn't like that coral as much as this. And I thought, I'm going to risk this. But she doesn't mention this one in her coral blush article this week. So anyway, I'm loving that, and I love the fact that it comes with a highlighter which I think blends it in beautifully. Now, the other thing I got, because I've been wanting to try this, last thing before I go, and this is by Pixi, and this is called, it says on their website it's new, but I think it's been out for a little while. It's called Glowy Powder, Radiance Powder. Now, it is a kind of highlighter-y, blushy kind of thing. But the reason, there was a couple of reasons I wanted to try it. Right, and I think it comes in a lighter shade as well. There's a lighter one than this. Let me just swatch some of this on my hand. It feels quite creamy when you... It's quite blingy, and I actually put this on as a primer and thought, and I look like the Tin Man, but it was quite good to go under flawless foundation because it counteracted the mattifying thing. But there was another reason that I wanted to get this. Let's just put some of this on my lid for a minute. I'll just dab some over my... There was another reason I wanted to get this, and I was intrigued by it because it's one of her products that's got not just vitamin C in it, but it's got ferulic acid in it. Ferulic acid, vitamin C, jojoba oil. It's got, so jojoba oil, vitamin C, and it's got triglycerides, and it's got ferulic acid. And ferulic acid and vitamin C is what's in my serum, and they're supposed to be very good combination of ingredients that gets rid of pigmentation. And I thought, I was intrigued by the fact that they're putting it in a makeup product. So I thought, and especially as a lot of my pigmentation is around where you would want to put a highlighter, I thought, gotta try that, because it's got some good skincare in it as well. Now, I've lost my highlighter brush. Just one second. Right, ordinarily, I wouldn't want to put it over this lovely blush, but I'm just going to put it over just to show you what it looks like. So it does impart a lovely glow to the skin. So if you got, like, you've put flawless foundation on, can you see the difference between that side, which is the more subtle Natasha Denona, and that? It does leave a lovely glow. And so if you've got hyperpigmentation like myself, and you have got the brown spots, cheek peaks, whatever, this might be worth looking at. Now, I don't know, you know, just how much effective it's going to be in makeup, but I just like the idea. They're quite high up in the ingredient list as well. The vitamin C and the ferulic acid. And considering I'm putting that on in a serum form, and it means that I can apply it over my makeup in the areas where I've got most of my brown spots. Because let's face it, you get most of your pigmentation where the sun naturally hits, which is where you want to put the highlighter. So it's a win-win. And it was quite reasonably priced as well. Let me just look up the price and I'll let you know what it is. Okay, it was £14. Now, she does do some other glowy powders, but be careful if you're looking. Now, there's a couple of things I would want to say about this. When I saw this on Look Fantastic and also on Pixi's website, it looked more peachy than it actually is, because when it looks a lot pinker in the palette, and then when you just look at it there, it looks actually, it's got quite a bit of pink in it. It's still peachy, but it's got more pink in it than it looks like on the website. Okay, so be careful. But I still love it and I think it looks great. And the other thing I wanted to say is that if you're going for this, you will see that she does glowy powders in other shades. And she does another one. This one's called Peachy Glow. No, sorry, this is called Peach Dew. She's got one called Peachy Glow. And there's some other ones, but be careful because they don't have this plus Vit C on the front. And this is the new one that's got vitamin C and ferulic acid in the formula. Those other shades don't have vitamin C and ferulic acid. So when you're going for it, if you want to have a look, it's probably easier to check out, even if you end up getting it from Look Fantastic, have a look on Pixi's website. And make sure that you get one of them. I'm not sure if there's other shades in this, but make sure you get the one that says vitamin C and ferulic acid. If you're getting it for the same reason as I was getting it, which is I want the skincare in my makeup. Okay, so I hope that's been helpful. I did get a little sample thrown in with my order. Let me just show you what that is. I have tried some bath care of this brand before, but I wasn't overly excited about it. But this is actually face cream and it says energy and anti-age. Probably something I will wait until I'm travelling and put it in. I keep up samples for when I'm away from home and then I can just take them with me. Quite a generous little sample. It's can't remember how many mils. It doesn't say, and my eyesight has had it. So, but anyway, there's my hand. There's a sample, quite generous sample from them. So I'm very impressed with Look Fantastic. So if you're watching anybody from Look Fantastic, Well done. I think that has got to be the fastest delivery. And when I told Rebecca, she said, is there a distribution centre in your living room? I think there must have been. So well done. In less than 10 hours, it was delivered to my front door. I'm totally stunned. All right. I hope you've enjoyed my two videos today. And I think it's about time now I go and put my feet up and have something to eat and go to bed. Take care. Thanks for joining me again. And thank you all for your lovely comments and support. You know I love you all. And sleep tight. See you very soon. Bye-bye. Mwah.